Hello, so we are in Saveurs again, and it's still Christmas period, and so today we're gonna do a Christmas pudding. The other day we made a Christmas cake, and today is Christmas pudding time. So there's lots of ingredients as every cake, and today we're having my little 40 who's gonna help us. So I think we need to cut the apples first, peel the apple. So we got some Brandley apple, cooking apple. Mix of raisin, sultana, cranberry, candy peeled, date, breadcrumb, safe raising flour, some soot, shredded soot, this one is beef, and lots of brandy, and even Guinness. It's very alcoholic cake, pudding. No, not that one. And usually, again, the traditional one, it's made with soft brown sugar. But again, we prefer using the light brown sugar because it's too dark. It's not very appetizing. Here we go. So let's peel the apple. Yeah, so we need 4, I think. So for this recipe, we need 500 grams of dry mixed fruit, 50 grams of dates, 25 grams of candy peel, 75 grams of breadcrumbs, 1 apple, Bramley, 100 grams of flour, self-raising flour, 100 grams, 100 grams of shredded soot. Then spices, we're having half or even a teaspoon of cinnamon, a teaspoon of nutmeg, and 180 of light brown sugar, 25 grams of flaked almond or pieces of almond, one lemon zest, and 75 grams of Guinness and 75 grams of brandy. So it's lots of ingredients. That's why it's so rich, maybe. Right. But we just need to grate the apples. Put a lot. Lots. Ready, my sexy, eh?
It's ready.
Okay, so we're starting to put all our fruits. All of them, candy peel. Dates. The breadcrumbs. A shredded apple, cooking apple. Basically all dry product, really. And I forgot to mention, needs on the recipe, needs 2 eggs. uh, 720 of sugar, is that right? Yeah, because we did double the recipe, 4 times the recipe. Yes, it is. So for you, it's gonna be 180 sugar. The sugar, zest, 2 lemon, yeah. For you it's only 1. Spices, cinnamon, nutmeg, you can always adjust the spice later on. Smell good.
I know you very well.
The shredded suet. Shredded suet. Voilà. Clean hands, flour. How many flour, ma poule? 400 for us. It's not a thing we're doing every day already. Yeah, so self-raising. So we need to crack 8 eggs for ourselves because it's 4 times the recipe. So make sure 1 egg is 50 grams. Huh?
Yes.
What do you want? Oh yeah, sorry. But I got clean hands now, can I?
Yes, you are.
Yes. Clean hands on a dirty body. So we mix all those dry fruits, everything, and then we're gonna add our liquid, eggs, and alcohol. It smells already amazing. Is that right, yeah? So you want to break down a bit the apple pieces. Voilà. Smell good, huh?
It's lovely.
He's a liar, he doesn't like it.
I don't like flavor, I like smell.
So the eggs come in, then the Guinness. And the brandy, yeah, so we need for us 300. And for you, 75. So I carry on with my hand, huh?
Yeah.
Maybe better. Oh, that's all. So it doesn't look like a cake mix at all, because there is so few flour, and it's just a pudding, really. No, no. We need some flaked almond. So for us, 100 grams for us. So give a very good malaxing. That's why you need your hands already. In a mixer it will work, but you know it might break too much your raisins and fruits, and so it will be a shame. It's nice to keep them whole. That's not too much, eh? No? Let's put a bit more. Put another 100, no? So let's rectify your recipe. instead 25 gram of almond, you're gonna put 50 gram, because you see it doesn't look much. Give a bit of crunch. We should have put roasted almond to give some extra flavor.
Yeah, but it's still cooking, so it might be.
It's moist. It's gonna cook in the bain-marie. Oh, you could have think about that. Did you? Let's be fancy, let's put some pistachio.
Pistachio would be good again.
We got some roasted one already.
Yes.
Why not? We just crack them quickly now.
Yeah, how much do you think?
$200 like the almond.
$200 be quite strong flavor.
Now it's gonna be good, my poule. Nutty. Need to try the flavor of the spice. Yeah. Yeah, spice is fine. Even an orange zest would be good. Well, we got the peel.
Yeah.
We got candy peel. Oh, look! Oh, sorry. Thank you. He's annoying me, so. Are you okay?
I'm good.
Oh, bah voilà. The mix is done. With those nutty, roasted nuts, it's gonna be nice. Interesting. So this, we're gonna cover it. And leave it in the fridge, mature the flavor all night long for 24 hours. And then tomorrow we're gonna cook it. So let's wait and see till tomorrow. Okay, so our Christmas pudding mix has been in the fridge for at least 12 hours. And now it's ready to cook it. So it did help the marinated of all the flavors to soak all the raisins, sultanas. It's all nada. Okay. So to cook it, there is different process on a bain-marie for sure, or in a pan. Or in an oven on a tray with water underneath. So I think is what we're gonna do. So, ma poule, the mix is ready. Smell good, oh no. Okay, hey Farta, do you have any melted butter?
Yes, chef.
Shut up. Hey, do that again, I slap your face. So, yeah, in the bain-marie?
Yes.
Should we put it on a little ring? Yeah, I think so. How many balls do we have? Eight? So I'm gonna boil quickly some water for the bain-marie, yeah?
Yes, sir.
So okay. It's very sticky, all soggy. Yeah, it's very good. I love to put more brandy, but maybe we put some after the cooking. We're gonna need some tea foil, ma poule. Yeah. It's gonna be nice with the roasted pistachio. Huh?
Oh yeah, that would increase flavor.
So I really need to press it, see? Get off your finger. Yeah, voilà. Actually, we need a greaseproof paper. And then tin foil. That means it's gonna steam a little bit with all this flavor inside. Just a square, huh? No?
Yeah.
Come on, you're so slow. Let's put a dash of brandy before to put the paper. Yeah?
More brandy, better.
Yeah. Nobody's driving at Christmas time.
No.
Yeah, just to say, yeah, no, no. Fine. Okay, give me a piece. So now tin foil. To keep all the steam inside. Be all right, no? So in a bain-marie like that, okay, so 120 degrees in the oven for at least 5 hours. After 5 hours you check one, and it should be like very cakey, I will say, kind of cooked. Put a knife anywhere inside. It's gonna come out moist because it's very dense and full of fruit, so it's gonna be come out like a sticky blade, but it's fine. Anywhere, people at Christmas time gonna re-steam it to eat it, so that's fine.